My name is Chris Boss, director of Lava Architects, and I came to Australia in 2002 to work with a big international architecture firm. Right. And as things sometimes go, we happened to win a competition for the National Swimming Center in Beijing, which was a fantastic project to work on and sort of put us and myself on the map in Australia and I think internationally.
Would that be your best design achievement to date, do you think?
I think the Water Cube in Beijing has a lot of ideas that drive me and my architecture for the last 10-15 years, and a lot of these ideas that we further develop in our current work. Ideas about sustainability, about lightness, about saving energy and material, but at the same time about being very exciting, contemporary, and sort of responding to the questions of the 21st century. I think that design works on many levels, in fashion, in furniture design, in architecture and interior design. Mm-hmm. The question is always to express the current state of society with your current technologies, your current means, your current materials. Yeah, in Customs House Sydney we did a project called The Green Void, which was essentially an interior installation with only 50 kilograms of material, but spanning an entire atrium of 22 meters by 15 meters. So following our principle of achieving more with less, more space, more architecture, more excitement, with less material, less energy and less cost. Nature is a great inspiration for us. We're inspired by things like the rainforest, ecosystems like the Great Barrier Reef, where thousands of species coexist with each other in symbiosis and in harmony. For us, that's a metaphor for the city and for the way that humans should live together.
Okay. What have you found most interesting about collaborating on climate?
Well, I think as architecture and design should always reflect the state of the society that we live in. Climate, in a very interesting way, incorporates ideas of current work scenarios, of evolutionary scenarios, of teamwork, of flexible team approaches, of hot desking, of working at home, flexible working hours, and not the idea of a rigid 9-to-5 day at your fixed spot with your fixed neighbors and your fixed workload. Mm-hmm. We've designed these screens, and the screens are very much inspired by these ideas of coral reefs and rainforests or pebbles or spider webs. And the screens can move. The screens move and the porosity of the screen changes while they're moving. So two people sitting opposite each other can talk to each other, but they can also shut each other out if they wish to do so. Right. And it adds sort of a level of the informal into an office space. And it's very colorful, playful, and organic. When you think about how much time we spend at work as opposed to time we spend at home, you want work to be a little bit like home, and these days home becomes a little bit like your workspace. So the boundaries are blurring. I think the traditional work scenario or the corporate scenario is a hierarchical scenario, which is very much a top-down approach. And we've come to the realization that in the 21st century it's more about bottom-up, about empowering the people who actually do the work and make the people who do the work happy. And that has a lot to do with giving them the freedom to form their own space and to inform the environment. And these screens are designed in a way that they can be interchanged. So many different versions of these screens will appear in the future. The fun part about it is the way you can interact between these screens. If you think of this as a solid screen, Eric, do you just want to sit on the other side? If you think of this as a solid screen, you can't actually see the other side and your co-worker.
Yes.
And now that it's porous and has all these openings, you have continuous eye-to-eye contact, but without being distracted by them. That almost it frames your co-worker in a different way. Yeah. And if you want to make closer contact, then you just move them away.
Yeah.
And so then all of a sudden you sit next to each other.
Yeah.